Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another awesome project. So let's get cracking. Friends, this is the Tinkercad dashboard, and it's where you'll find all your amazing designs. Whenever you want to relaunch a design, like today we're going to add something to our house design, you click Tinker This. After a moment, your design will load and you'll be ready to make your modifications. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is for editing, I'm going to go back to a plain background, and I'm also going to turn on that work plane and click back here so we can get to work. Now, friends, if you missed this tutorial, I'll make sure there's a link up here in the corner. It takes less than 15 minutes and you'll have this cute little house. Friends, it was brought to my attention that my door is shorter than my windows, which is kind of silly. Let me show you how to fix it. First, click on your windows and we want to lock them. We do not want them to change, but we want to change everything else. Now we're going to ungroup and we're going to ungroup and we're going to ungroup to finally get to those doors. We want to hide the building. And that lets you see the door and the hole. And then we're gonna shift stretch till they're the same height. Now ours can all be different, so I'm gonna make sure it's just close. If we look at that from an angle, my door is a little higher than my windows, which is perfect. You can see the blue windows inside each of those. Now friends, I wanna protect that door. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hide that hole, click on the door, and then we can lock it as well. So all our windows and doors are locked. Now if we do show all, we can select all of this. Notice it says 8 shapes, but the windows and the door are locked. So when we group it, boom, we've still got all our separate pieces. How cool is that? Of course, when this scaled, it got too big. So we do need to shrink it down to the correct size too, so that it fits. My favorite way to change that measurement is to just click the box, hit 2 and press enter. We do need to line them up. I'm gonna select those two shapes, do a line, and bingo, get that back where it was supposed to be. Now friends, when you think about a house, you get to pick what you wanna add. Today I'm gonna show you how to add shutters. We're gonna simply bring out the cube and set it on the building. Squish it down so that it is the shutter size that you want. I'll let you pick whatever measurements you think look good on your house. I'll show you my numbers when I think I've got it where I want it. I think that is going to be reasonable. Notice I'm scrolling in to get it close to the edge. If you want to change your nudge to make finer adjustments, you can simply adjust it right there. And then of course I want the thickness to be right. That would be crazy thick. This is more the thickness, 0.75 of a real shutter. Now the color for this that I'm going to choose is a green. It'll match my roof. That looks pretty doggone awesome, friends. Now I'm gonna click on it, do Control D. Let's make sure our nudge is set to 1 millimeter. And I'm just gonna move that across so it's right beside the building. If we do F to fit view, we can double check and make sure it's exactly like we want. I do want it closer to that edge. I'm gonna turn on a 0.25 nudge or a 0.1 nudge until it's exactly the way I want. That's perfect. Friends, this is where it's kind of cool. We can now shift select those two. And if we do Control D, it nudges out. It memorized that movement from a moment ago. I'm going to switch back to a 1, and I'm just going to nudge them over. I could also do shift nudge to make it a little faster. Of course, there's my F to fit view. Here's my 0.1 nudge. And let's get it right where it needs to go. And that looks pretty darn awesome. If we zoom out, we have got shutters on our windows. I'm gonna click here and use that F to fit view, and I'm gonna look around the corner. I want to put this over here with a duplicate. So first, Control D is duplicate. You may have noticed it blinked. Now I'm gonna click cruising, which is the letter C, and I just want to grab this one and I want to set it over here. Now I do want these to be aligned, so I'm gonna put the work plane on the ground. And I'm going to shift select this, and I want the heights to be the same. So I'm going to do a line, and I want that dot. Now it did it the wrong way, so I'm going to undo it, and I'm going to do a line again, and I want to remember to make this one the master. Now when I do this, you'll see that nudged downward just a little bit. Over here, we're going to do Control D. Let's do that shift nudge to move it across. And let's zoom in and make this just a little bit more perfect. I think that is pretty awesome. Next up on the outside of our house is a doorknob, friends. These two pieces make a pretty sweet doorknob. Let me show you how. When you bring the cylinder out, just stick it on your wall. We're going to make the sides smoother by sliding that all the way up. And notice this is huge. We're just going to do shift shrink, and we're going to take it all the way down to size 2. This will be the handle for the doorknob. I'm going to use my arrow keys or shift nudge to get it where I want. Notice shift nudge is because it's still set to 0.1. I think that's a decent height. If we do F for fit view and look at it from a side, it's a little bit thick, so I'm going to squeeze it back in. We are going to add the knob by simply bringing that sphere out and setting it on top of that cylinder. Now we're going to use shift squeeze to make it small enough. I'm going to go all the way down to size 4. I'm going to click on it and I'm going to flatten it so that way it looks like the knob. Now we simply need to shift select them, choose a line, and we want to make it in the middle on the front, and we want to make it on the middle up and down. I'm going to select those two and do Control G to group them. I'm going to change them to a gold color. I'm going to use this one right here. And then I'm going to shift squeeze to get it just a little smaller. I think that looks pretty darn nifty. If you want it to be a little bit different size, don't forget you can also scale with 0.1 so you can be a little bit more precise. And then, of course, place it right where you want. How cool is that? The last thing we're going to add today is a wicked cool welcome mat. Simply bring it out. Let's just shrink the top, squeeze it down so it looks like a welcome mat. Set it in front of your door. Pick the color you want. I'm going to go back to the presets and I'm going to go with a dark brown. And then it is time to add words. We can do that with the sweet text option. Notice you can cruise the text right on top and you can pick whatever words you want. I am going to do welcome. I'm going to pick an awesome color. I'm going to go with a yellow, I think. And then I'm going to shift squeeze to make it tiny. Now I can drag it right back to that shape. When I get it to the edge, now I'm going to stretch these out and use the black handles to get them exactly where the way I want. And I'm going to push them down into the mat. Take the two of them and do group, which is also Control G. Notice it turns one color. You can fix that by simply going to multicolor. How fun is that? Friends, that's how quickly you can modify and have fun making your house more awesome. Don't forget, you can add all sorts of windows and any other things you can think of. You can also sneak down into creatures and characters and find people that you can add to your cool project. Of course, once you bring in, hold down shift and shrink them to the size you want. Friends, I'm going to wrap up, of course, by clicking on the settings and getting that background set. Today, I'm going to go with a light blue, and of course, I'm going to shut off that grid. Click back here, and don't forget, everything you create is saved to the Tinkercad cloud by simply clicking on the Tinkercad button. Of course, friends, one of the coolest things about making a design is when you get reactions. You can do that, of course, by going to the properties of your design, giving it a name, explain it in a description. Of course, if you tag it with HLMT23, I search that almost every day, and of course, I will give you a reaction. Of course, make it public, and I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, follow the tutorial, and gain some epic skills. So friends, in wrapping up, I just want to remind you about my website with all those awesome categories. Of course, the day one favorites, the useful starters, and the Tinkercad essentials. And of course, friends, do not forget the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to remind you about the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we have got a ton of members, and it's a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Don't forget, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.